Okay, welcome. This is James Possible, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the magic of gold. What you need to know about cash, what you need to know about gold, how it's affecting your spending power, how it's going to impact your retirement. And for many of you, you already know how it's impacting your retirement. It's not a good situation. So let's begin. Okay, I'm going to start with this quote from Alan Greenspan. In the absence of the gold standard, there is no way to protect savings from confiscation through inflation. There is no safe store of value. So what I'm going to illustrate throughout this video is that cash, your paper money, your coins, whether it's whether you keep it in your wallet, your purse, under your bed, you know, wherever you keep it, even if it's in the bank, it will not hold value. It will lose value. And when he says confiscation through inflation, I'm also going to cover that in this video, because what he is saying, because paper money and coins are not backed by gold, every time money is printed, you are losing money, because when money is printed, inflation is created. It's unavoidable. There is no such thing as no inflation when money is being printed, especially when there is nothing backing the money. And this is true globally. This is true in every country. It's called a fiat currency, which I'll talk about in another video. Okay, so let's move on. Gold, right? We're talking about the magic of gold. How do you protect yourself with gold? So I'm going to talk about gold. What's so magical about gold, right? And then I'm also going to talk about a little bit how you can protect yourself with gold, because that's important. What you may not know, gold is the oldest and safest store of value. For thousands of years, gold has been sought out and by kings and queens, emperors and such. Look at today. Every single country wants more gold. Every single country is accumulating more gold. Why? Because gold is a store of value. Gold is how they plan to protect themselves. Gold reduces the cost of inflation. What does this mean? Gold is a hedge with inflation. In other words, gold will help you preserve your spending power. It will help you fight inflation. So no matter what the government is doing, the government, the politicians, with your money, gold is the way to protect yourself. Gold protects your spending power. Now, this is the cornerstone of everything I'm talking about. Because inflation is really an awkward thing to understand. Like, you logically can talk it out and it makes sense, but how do you really understand inflation? Well, the only way you really can understand inflation is when you look at it as spending power. 10 years ago, $100 would have bought you what? Can you buy that same thing or same things today with that same $100 cash? Or is the $100 of cash that you have today literally worth less than it was 10 years ago? I mean, answer that question. When you go to the grocery store and you're buying food, are you getting more for your dollar or less for your dollar today than you did 10 years ago? It's your spending power that inflation affects more than anything else. So I'm going to break it down in a couple different examples. And this first example is 12 loaves of bread. And then I'm going to talk about trucks, buying a new Ford truck. And then I'm going to really, really break it down for you, okay? So quick example, 1912, 12 loaves of bread, $1.12. Or with that same $1.12, you could have bought a gram of gold, and that gram of gold would have been enough, had enough value in it to buy 12 loaves of bread, right? So a gram of gold was worth about $1.12 back in 1912, 2019. Fast forward to today, 12 loaves of bread, a gram of gold today is worth about $45 and change. And interesting enough, with $45 and change, you could buy 12 loaves of bread. So 1912, a gram of gold, 2019, a gram of gold. Saving money is not the answer. And why isn't it the answer? It's because of inflation. It's because of what the politicians are doing. It's because of what the governments are doing. They are literally stealing money from you every time they print money. You, as an everyday citizen, could not do legally what the politicians and the governments are allowed to do. You would go to jail if you manage your finances the way the governments and the politicians are doing it today, through the central banking system. It's a system of debt. And every time money is printed through that system, you are losing value. Your money loses value. Your spending power is reduced. And here's a great chart. This chart starts back in 1913. A dollar was worth a dollar. You can see it declined, came back up. You can see in 1933, they were messing with gold, right? They actually outlawed gold. Think about that. They outlawed gold. Desperate governments do desperate things. And then in 1944, they decided to back the currency, the dollar. They decided to back the dollar with gold, with physical gold. In other words, you could exchange a dollar for a dollar of gold. And in 1971, Nixon took us off the gold standard, and now it's just paper money. And so today, in 2013, the dollar was worth, 5 cents. Today, it's worth less than 5 cents. Modern day money, money as we know it today, the cash in your hand, the change in your pocket, is not a store of value. Over time, your money, your cash, is worth less. The longer you hold your money, the longer you hold your cash, no matter if it's in a savings or otherwise, the more money you will lose. Cash is not the answer. 1920, here's our truck example. A new Ford truck, 1 kilogram of gold, or $645. So $645 would have bought you a new truck in 1920, and it would have also bought 1 kilogram of gold. Fast forward to today, 2019, a new Ford truck, $50,000 cash, and you could buy a truck. That same $50,000 today could buy 1 kilogram of gold. 1 kilogram of gold, or just 1 kilogram, period, is equal to about 35.27 ounces. 35 ounces, over 35 ounces of gold. Think about that. Okay, this is a great, great, great quote by Sam Ewing, one of my favorites. Inflation is when you pay $15 for a $10 haircut you used to get for $5 when you had hair. It's just stupid. It's crazy. Inflation happens because of irresponsible money management on the part of politicians and governments. Every time money is printed by a government, and I don't care what government it is, this is happening globally. Again, it's criminal. If this doesn't upset you, I don't know. You must not be breathing. You need to understand this. Because if you're thinking about retirement, you might as well forget it, because they're printing more money today than they have ever printed in our history. Which means your money is losing value so fast. Your spending power is just floating away with every printing. And they are printing money on a daily basis. This should concern you. This should upset you. They are literally stealing money from you. Okay, so let's break those examples down that I just showed you. Really break them down with some pictures and whatnot. So cash versus gold. 12 loaves of bread, right? 1912, $1.12, or a gram of gold. 2019, same 12 loaves of bread. a gram of gold or $45 in change in cash. Okay, so what does that look like? Let's really look at that. It's easy to read it, but I want you to see it. Okay, so there's $1.12. Simple enough, right? We fast forward to today and look at that. That's $45 in change. That is insane. Think about that. In other words, in 1912, you had $1.12. To have the same spending power today in 2019, you would have to have 40 times more. 40 times, well, actually almost 41 times more cash than you had in 1912. We're talking about retirement. Did you ever consider that you would need almost 41 times more money than you have today to retire? In fact, the way they're printing money today, it's stupid how much money you're going to need to retire. If you don't do something today, if you don't start doing something today, you might as well just forget about retirement. And the government doesn't care. The politicians don't care. They're taken care of. They get to print money whenever they need the money. The banks get to be irresponsible, and the governments will bail them out. They are not concerned about your spending power. They are not concerned about your quality of life. That's what we're talking about here, your quality of life. If all you did was hold on to $1.12, and now you're in 2019 with that same $1.12, think about that. You can't even buy a loaf of bread. Or better yet, let's talk about the loaf of bread that you could buy today with $1.12. How much nutritional value does that bread, the quality of the bread that you can buy today for $1.12, have? Yeah, not much. But here's the beauty of gold. Here's the magic of gold. 1912, 1 gram of gold. 2019, same 1 gram of gold. So 1 gram of gold in 1912, same 1 gram of gold in 2019. And guess what? They both buy the same thing. You couldn't do that with cash, but somehow you can do that with gold. It's amazing. This is part of the magic of gold. But has anybody ever taught you that? So instead of giving a bond as a gift in 1912, what would have happened if they just bought a gram of gold and given that as a gift? Think about that. Instead of giving cash as a gift, start giving gold as a gift. Because in gold, you're literally changing the financial future of somebody. Cash won't mean anything in their future life, at least not the cash you're giving them. Okay, let's look at the next example, cash versus gold. New Ford truck, 1920, 2019. In 1920, that Ford truck cost $645. 1 kilogram of gold. In 2019, that new Ford truck cost about $50,000 or 1 kilogram of gold. So what does that look like in cash? Let's talk about that. Okay, it's easy. In 1920, six $100 bills, two 20s, and one $5 bill. Simple enough, right? Fast forward to 2019, and now look what we have. Instead of, what do we have? We have nine bills, so we have six 100s, two 20s, and one 5. Instead of that, today we have five stacks of $10,000. So we have five stacks with $100 bills in each stack. So over, we have 500 $100 bills versus six $100 bills, a couple 20s and a five. The difference is huge. Huge. It's just crazy. And this is happening because of inflation. This is happening because of poor economic decisions by politicians. In fact, you could say they were criminal decisions. And the fact that they have the ability to just print money at will. Think about that. $645 in 1920. Today in 2019, $50,000. Put that into perspective. Think about that as your retirement. Think about that as your future life. It's what we have today isn't working. It's broken. The system we have today is broken. And it's broken globally. It's not just here in the United States. It's every country. The irresponsibility of politicians and governments, somehow it's happening globally, everywhere. And the central banks are making it easy for this to happen. But here's the beauty. 1920, 1 kilogram of gold. Remember, 35 ounces of gold. 2019, the same 1 kilogram of gold. 1920, a kilogram of gold, new truck. 2019, a kilogram of gold, a new truck. Are you following the trend? Again, a kilogram is equal to 35.27 ounces. Are you seeing the correlation here? Is cash the answer? Just think about it. It's a simple question. Based on what you're seeing, is cash the answer? If you're not saying no, then you need to rewatch this video. Okay, Milton Friedman. Inflation is one form of taxation that can be imposed without legislation. Think about that. So the governments and the politicians have the ability to print money at will without any legislation, without you having a voice, a vote, a say in the printing of that money. And as he says, a form of taxation. It might as well be called that, because what they're doing when they print money, they are taking money from you and I. The value of your money, the spending power of your money is going down. Again, if this is not upsetting you, then you're not understanding something. Because the way it's set up today, they are printing more money than ever. And the printing of that money is costing you, me, and every other working family a quality of life in the future that they have today. You will not have the same quality of life in the future that you have today if they keep printing money the way they are printing it, and all you do is hold on the cash. It won't happen. It's not possible. If you don't start taking some action today, it's your future, your financial future, the quality of your future is just not going to be the same. And if you don't care about you, what about your family? What about your children? Do you care about the quality of life that they are going to have to live? That's what we're talking about here. So what does this mean for you? No matter what, saving cash will not work. It just won't work. Whether you save your cash in a jar, in a can, buried out back, believe it or not, I know people that are burying money. Well, I know of people that are burying money in their backyard because they're so afraid of losing their money. And see, this is the insanity of inflation. This is the insanity of governments and politicians working together to print more money with the central banks. You can't see it. The net effect of inflation, the loss in spending power, is not visible. So, but it's experienced every time you go to the store. Think about that. Every time you go to the store to spend money, to purchase, to purchase groceries, to purchase essential products, you know, and even to purchase things that just offer you a better quality of life, it costs more. As a rule, saving cash will not work. And I said, as a rule, why? Well, because you have to start somewhere, right? You get paid in cash, whether it's deposited automatically into your bank account, whether they give you a check and you have to cash the check, or whether they give you cash. You're paid in cash. Whatever your currency is, you're paid in cash. So you have to start with cash. But what do, right? Do you know what to do? Step one, you start to trade your cash for gold. That's what you have to do. There's easy ways to do that, and then there's hard ways to do that. Do you want to do the easy way or the difficult way? Again, I can't express this enough. The sooner you start, the more you save, the better quality of life you're going to have in the future, the sooner you start trading your cash for gold. Now that you know, isn't it time you learn how to protect your future? Isn't it time you learn how to protect your financial future, your quality of life? Text the word MAGIC to 405-293-8388. If you're out of the United States, just add the country code plus one. Again, text the word MAGIC to 405-293-8388 if you want to know the easy way to trade your cash for gold. There are other ways to do it, but they're not as easy to do. You know what to do. Talk to you soon.